ruby laser. It's a solid state laser and it's a three level laser system. So what is meant by ruby? A combination of Al2O3 with doped with Cr3 plus ions is called a ruby rod or ruby crystal. Since you have to dope Cr3 plus by a weight of 0.05% by weight. So the combination of this is known as ruby crystal. So now by using this ruby rod, we are going to produce a laser now. So the active medium is Al2O3 doped with Cr3 plus now. So coming to our general procedure, first take the active medium, ruby rod. Since ruby rod is pink in color. Now, after taking the active medium, keep the active medium in between two mirrors such a way that one is 100% silver, another one is less than 100% silver. Here, no need of external mirrors. In helium neon laser, we have to take the helium neon, it's a gaseous laser, so you have to take the helium neon in a gas and you have to keep an external mirrors. But here it's a solid, so no need of external mirrors. Just polish the two ends with perfectly and paint one end with 100% silver, another end with less than 100% silver. So automatically the active medium ruby rod is in between two mirrors. And next, for the excitation process, we have to keep the ruby rod in a helical xenon flash lamp. This is helical xenon flash lamp. Xenon flash lamp. So why it is called flash lamp is the circuit arrangement of this lamp consisting of a capacitor. While capacitor is discharging, it will on condition. While capacitor is charging, it is in off condition. So now, in total, it will never give you continuous light. It will give you on-off light like flashes. So now we have taken our setup is ready. We have to keep the active medium in between two mirrors, and for our pumping process, we are giving a light energy. Since for pumping process, we are using light energy. That's why it will come under optical pumping. So this we are going to see the general processor now. So by giving energy, by applying the electrical energy to the helical xenon flash lamp, the chromium atoms in the ruby rod will absorb the energy of a white light is incident on the ruby rod, and in that white light the chromium atoms will absorb green wavelength and blue wavelength. So by absorbing green wavelength and blue wavelength, it will broaden into bands the energy levels, and it will by absorbing a wavelength of 5500 angstroms, it will goes to the 4F2 level. By absorbing 4000 angstroms, it will goes to the blue 4F1 level. This is called blue absorption and it is called green absorption. So now, since these energy levels are not metastable state, it will contain a metastable doublet state. That means these two energy levels are metastable state. So the atoms which are in excited state will comes to the metastable doublet states like this. So now here it is a metastable state, so the atoms will spend more time there. Automatically the population inversion is achieved between the metastable doublet state and the ground state. So while it is coming down, it produces the laser light. It will produce a wavelength of 6,943 angstroms or 6,929 angstrom units. In total, it will produce around 6,900 wavelength. It is which is in red in color. That's why the output of ruby laser is red in color. That's why this rod is called ruby laser. Ruby means red in color. The output of this ruby by using this Al2O3 and Cr3 plus combinations, we are getting a red color output laser. That's why it is called ruby laser. Now, the disadvantage in this is by giving energy, the while chromium atoms are coming out, it releases enormous amount of heat energy. So due to that heat energy, the entire system may collapse. That's why to cool the system, we have to take the entire ruby rod in a cooling chamber. Like this. It's a cooling chamber. So it will cool whenever it is get heated. Whenever the ruby rod get heated, it cools the system like this. So this is your ruby rod. By giving energy, the ruby rod will get heated. While Cr3 plus ions are breaking the bond and going to excited state, it heat up the system. To cool the system, we are giving in a cooling chamber. Now, the output of ruby laser is not a continuous one. It's a pulsated one. Pulsated means we will never get the output as a continuous light. As we already discussed, the helical xenon flash lamp is containing a capacitor. Due to this capacitor, it will never go continuously. Whenever it switch on, the chromium atoms will absorb the energy and goes to the higher energy state. While it is coming down, you will get a output. When it is in off condition, it will never excite. There is no output. So it is in off condition. Whenever it switches on, it will absorb the energy and goes to excited state. You will get output. So you will get a pulsated output in a ruby laser. Whereas in helium, you will get a continuous laser light. So this is about ruby laser. And this is a small note is, don't think that by absorbing 5500 angstroms, it is going to the lower energy state. The reason behind this is, as we already know that the energy of a photon is E equals to h nu, where nu is the frequency of the photon, and we can write this as hc by lambda. So if more wavelength is there, less energy is there. Since the chromium atoms are absorbing, by switch on the flash lamp, white light is falling on the ruby rod. In that ruby rod, the chromium atoms are absorbing the energy. The chromium atoms will respond only for green and blue wavelengths, not for all the wavelengths. And since by absorbing a wavelength of 5500, which is high energy, high wavelength, if it is high wavelength, it is absorbing less energy. If it is absorbs less energy, it will go to the lowest energy level only. Since it is absorbing 4000 angstroms, so while it is absorbing 4000 angstroms, less wavelength, more energy. So it is absorbing more energy means it will go to the excited state. So this is the logic behind that one. So don't think that by absorbing 5500, it is not absorbing the wavelength, it is absorbing the energy. So keep that in mind. And here also the same, while it is coming from here to here, it will produce only 6929 angstroms, means more energy. When it is coming from this level to this level, it will emit more energy, means less wavelength. Whenever it is coming from this level to this level, it is emitting less wavelength. Less energy means more wavelength, 6943. On an average, both are having less energy gap. That's why both will emit a very fractional change, not fractional change, very narrow change, 6943 and 6929 angstroms.